शुभ संध्या और शुभमस्तु से स्टार्ट करता हूं। माय डियर ऑडियंस, माय फ्रेंड्स, गीता मैडम जी एंड उषा जी एंड मंजू जी, टुडे द टॉपिक वी आर डिस्कसिंग इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग वन, बट इफ आई रियली हैव टू पुट इट अक्रॉस टू यू, स्पीकिंग अबाउट माइंड इज वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट सब्जेक्ट, बिकॉज दिस सब्जेक्ट has got a different opinions, different connotation and formation in the psychological world. No one particular idea will fit into everybody. This is the one thing that never fits into everybody. Yet, we can throw light on certain aspects of it and we can take your mind near to correction. Mindset. Let me start with a quote. Today morning I placed it. There is no music hidden in musical instrument. Please mark my word. There is no music hidden in musical instrument. It is the musician who is the soul of the instruments, and music is master, not musical instrument. So the very understanding here is human body. Similarly, our Atma is the master of our life, not the body. Why struggle too much? Once Atma leaves, the body dies. Lead a life of contentment. You should always be content with what you are achieving in your life and not keep on troubling yourself with more and more. Dil mange more is something, you know, you have to face also a lot of other musics also. Our most precious sense is mindset. The capacity to envision our life is the most satisfying form. But mindset is much more than what we just mentally feel or seeing or visualizing our life at its best. It is an attitude, a plan of action. It is a dream and the ability to make the dream come true. This is the most important factor. In a short 15 minutes, we can talk about mindset. Fortunes are made in human mind. Fortunes are not visible, but before that it is made in human mind. Because your mind is your computer. It is your processing unit. And you believe it or not, that since childhood to till date, as I am addressing more to the teaching faculties, so I am just trying to tell you all, whatever you have seen right from your childhood, maybe from 8th year age to till date, please note my point, they are already stored in your mind. Where the problem is, we all say that I have forgotten some of the things and some of the things I remember. But actually mind has not forgotten a single one. As you have stored lot of files in your computer and you use your mouse to direct the cursor to ultimately take to the file and open, similarly, the mind has a beauty that whenever you come across that particular situation, whatever file it has stored, that is, it has seen and observed, it will remain there and it will recollect and start speaking from it. So many think that mind will only store what is by-hearted. Not necessary. There is a Hindi word. When pani pura ghade mein agar bhar jata hai, to uske baad wo bahar gir jata hai. So whenever you store something beyond its required capacity, it will vanish. So whatever your mind has seen and observed during your lifespan, maybe 25 years, 30 years or 40 years, it will always be remaining inside. So that is why we spiritual people suggest everybody that you start recollecting things from the childhood. What you do in the childhood. In childhood, you observe everything what your parents do and duplicate it. That is the beginning of your mindset start functioning. But here, you are only duplicating and not using your original mind, but you are copying and pasting it. Which usually we do in research scholars nowadays in India or everywhere. They simply copy paste from everywhere and ultimately get a doctorate. Child also does the same. When the elders do, they say it is an achievement for them. But when the child does, we said he is only duplicating what I am telling, but he is not further developing. Actual fact is, till a particular age, the child will only duplicate. And that duplicate has got something beautiful in this. As he duplicates, a stage comes, he says, this is what I don't like and this is what I like. You start from the breakfast. He will first time start telling you at a particular age, maybe from 8th year or 9th year or 10th year, that look, I don't want this breakfast. His likes and dislikes is directed by his mind. He starts later, further he grows and starts examining things. That what is placed before him is worth probing. So he will probe. And he will start deciding what is right and wrong. That may not be right actually, or that may not be wrong actually. But he will start. And that next stage he comes is the stage of experimenting. Whatever he understands as right and wrong, his mind tells him to experiment it. He will take a screwdriver and start opening the TV. And bang comes the parents and beat him. Don't do that. Don't allow him to open the TV, fine. But he will do it because that curiosity, the experimenting, the probing and investigation is the nature of human mind. And he will automatically go and start opening it. And after that, whatever he started opening and seeing, he wants to experiment it by implementing his ideas. That we all do it. And those ideas are there stored in our mind right from a particular age, maybe from 10th year or maybe from 12th year or maybe from 15th year. And those are sometimes we also visualize as our dream. And dreams have a different connotation and formation. One of the idea behind a dream is what you see while sleeping is usually a hallucination, it is not a dream. But a dream that you see in the early hours, and if you had a proper sleep, maybe between 3 to 5, those dreams are the dreams that is coaxing you inside your mind to activate in your day-to-day working and put it in practice. This is a dream that Abdul Kalamji also spoke about, that a dream that keeps you awake, your mindset, if it keeps you awake, that's a dream which you can really achieve in your life. Then comes another stage. After experimenting your ideas and your some of your dreams, you start looking at it to implement, you meet failures. When you meet failures, your mind gives you a different direction. How to handle failures. Then comes a little success. Then again your mind achieves and says, look, I have done this. So when we are teachers, when we are going to deal with the kids, our main intention will be to put it into their mind is whatever they are acquiring in their mind, they have a right to implement it. They have a right to put it out. And unless we give them that opportunity, they will not debate with you. When they don't debate with you, they don't understand the discriminative power in the mind. Because mind's most important duty is to discriminate what is right and wrong. And above all this, sometimes the mind says, I am right. That is ego. You are right. It is ending up in argument. But what is right if the mind understands, then the child or the person involved, he grows. So always directing mind to that kind of approach is very, very important. What is mind? It is actually when you take birth and when you grow, you have nothing in the mind. It is something is born out of nothing. If you see a child born and the child grows, you will not see anything that he want to achieve. And after 45 years, you will find that he is the president of the country, or he has become the great scientist, or he is the best cricket player in the 20th year of age. That is not visible, but it is there hidden in the mind. That when we allow the child to understand how to unfold into real life, then the child will be in a position to take it forward. So my entire conceptualization while we teach to anyone, either it is to ourselves or the teaching faculties or to the students, we must clearly visualize what we want to achieve. Once we visualize in our mind, we probe into our mind, we investigate into our mind, then our thinking becomes stable. Once we stabilize our thinking, then only we can make it an output. Because output will not come unless everything is hidden in your mind. Mind is nothing but your storehouse. Entire files of your life is stored there. Your blueprint is there. The child's blueprint is there. So nothing is visible, but everything is hidden. Jeeva koku ruchi, puri koku buddhi. Some fantastic words that I tell you. This is a Telugu proverb. Jeeva koku ruchi means every tongue has a different taste. Puri koku buddhi means every head has a different intellect. This different intellect made Gita Ramanuja a storyteller. And a different intellect made Usha an academician. And made an Acharya Ajit a spiritual man. Your child will be a cricket player because his taste is there. However you try to stop him, and if you stop him and not allowing him to play, and you want to dump your mindset on him and telling that you have to become a doctor, he will end up as a compounder. The very important factor of parenting and teaching is observe the child where his taste is driving him. Where his intellect is supporting him, there lies his growth. There he will succeed. Otherwise, if you see, right from Rabindranath Tagore or Abraham Lincoln or Washington too, these are the people, great people, including our great cricketer Sachin Tendulkar, hardly they have any schooling. But they all became great to greatest. So we Indians from the beginning believe that certificate and degrees will not certify the intellectual ability of the human mind. Human mind can do wonders. That wonder is lying inside the child. That child becomes a teacher, that child becomes a scientist, the child becomes a sportsman, the child becomes a politician, whatever he is, it is his mindset. So we have to give him an opportunity in his life and always educate him and tell him that, hey, you observe yourself every day. First fundamental we have to teach our children, that ask them to observe themselves. Ask them to observe what they think. Initially we can tell him, here is a pad I am giving you, please write what you have thought in your mind. Let him write and scribble every day whatever he like. Let him prepare a book of his own, and after 10 years he can refer to that book, which will be the most useful book for his life. Nowadays computer is there, so children sit in front of laptop and PCs in the home, they can also type it inside. So human mind is nothing but the process begins with thinking, and many of you don't know, or know, I don't know, but 70,000 thoughts gets processed in a matter of 60 seconds. There will be no overlapping. The beauty of thinking process is there is no overlap. Mind is the most restless thing in the world. Mind is the most restless thing in the world. And the same mind can become very calm. From Narendranath, it can make a person Vivekananda. This is the capacity of the mind. It can handle the whole world. At the same time, it cannot handle a small issue of a small injury on your toe. Mind is a mystery. Whatever is unfolding, it is unfolding at this moment. And we have millions of books, authors, speakers who are speaking about mind continuously. And one theory or the other is developing. The reason is human mind wants to do something different always. Because each mind has got a different intellect and each mind has got a different understanding of their life. As I told you, your tongue has a different taste, your mind has a different thinking. So for the time which you have given me, I will say that I will conclude here only instead of dragging it further, because this subject cannot be dealt in 15 to 20 minutes. We take sessions of 72 hours on mind development. So thank you very much for giving me this opportunity, and let's continue.